If you're going to Scorpions, you're right.
During COVID, obviously other stuff.
No, I realized I forgot to bring my cable.
I have a cable.
Okay, cheers, thanks.
Hey, you can steal from my headbox over there whenever.
Okay, yeah, yeah, I'll take it. I don't know where my match is, so.
They became just known as sort of the TTRPG Magic group, and then the D&D club set up during COVID when no one knew them.
Oh, what play?
I mean, they were still fine for a while, but without a lot of their big events like Matacon and Feast every fall, so we go to Valley for 33 years.
Really?
Which is where we go camping in the woods and again, we come off into the story, sing some music, and then just nerd out, and you can be whoever you want to be without the eyes of society or whatever.
Of course, yeah.
Hang out.
I saw in the Discord like some alum talking.
Yeah,
and it's like they're people being like class of 94, and they're like still into that stuff.
Yeah, no, definitely. If you look in the nostalgia channel, they have pictures and stories.
That might have been where I saw it. Yeah. I just remember like
I have it muted just
around.
Because the first couple weeks they just entered the Discord.
Yeah.
And kind of reached out to them like, hey.
I've seen this probably.
There was some hacking in the previous groups because the last couple pilots were not talking to each other.
Okay.
And most of the clubs operate if they take money committing tax fraud.
Uh-huh.
But, you know, the old Manicons would, like, take in the $500.
Really?
I mean, we would spend $10,000 on flying a Destin in California, so.
Oh, is it like an actual Destin
club? We used to. We don't have the funds right now because stuff. However, we're hoping to make a good amount for next year.
Okay.
We used to have a lot of. I did a Duke Nukem voice actor one time.
Oh, yes. Sick.
Market.
At a like the Madison Comic Con, Madicon, they had the Duke Nukem voice actor once.
Yeah, I want to say
it's
that was 2012, 2013. The other most famous one we had was Margaret Wise in 2002. She and Tracy Hickman wrote the Dragonlance book series, The Dungeons and Dragons. The very first book series, it was, I don't know, it's really big in the
I don't really know, but I've heard.
No,
it sounds important.
Yeah. Like, normally she only goes to cons for several thousand people.
Yeah, exactly.
500 people. So,
I mean, 500, that's still a lot.
We're hoping for maybe 250 room, though. And that's, you know, the first year back, because last year we
yeah.
The pressure was quite right before you.
Okay. Yeah, that's pretty bad. So where are you going?
I'm doing about 40 minutes north here, New Market. So yeah, that's the main reason why I joined. Is like, well,
were you active
happen.
In it before?
So Spug, because it was a bigger like part of the industry, it was mainly Jane Guster. So
yeah.
I didn't know what I was doing. But I came to Matacon since I was a kid.
Yeah.
I would go to their LARP events or whatever, or we have close ties with the Wildlife Foundation in Virginia. So they would always bring in like birds and stuff, and then the big charity auction at the end to sell all their old bird stuff.
Okay, that's cool.
To people, and then all the money would go to Wildlife Foundation. And the 501st Legion would come, so like all the, you know, people dressed up in Star Wars stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I would just come to that. When it didn't happen last year, I was like, oh, well, you know, I'll try to help fix it, you know, assuming there was still people there. And then it turned out to be just our president, or former president, Chad.
Really? And what, he was like, I'm leaving your president
no,
now.
Well, yeah, no one really liked it anyway. He was just going to let it die at the end of the semester.
Oh, wow.
No one knew why they kept it. But we've got, like, 7 or 8
Okay.
So, and I mean, the alumni have said, hey, we'll volunteer for free.
No.
Yeah.
I just kind of want to get more clubs involved. The alumni actually won Gun Zero on campaign money.
Yeah, exactly.
So that was a lot of the people. Harrisonburg people.
Just students have to pay?
So if you work 5 hours at the event, which is 20 total hours, you get a free drink.
Okay. And if you don't, is it like...
I think the most they ever charged was a weekend was 25. We're going to do, I think, 20 this year.
Okay, that's not bad.
And then tournaments, we might do... I haven't decided on how much for them. Some of the bigger ones, like Warhammer and Magic, we might do $5 for those. But I've also thought about doing just a $5, like, all tournament pass.
Okay.
We'll have registration tables set up for all of it.
If you want to talk about, like, training and stuff, you forgot.
Well,
I
not not just fighting games.
Yeah, but also I know there is like you said, Warhammer.
Oh no, no, but just like video games in general.
Are there other games?
Oh yeah. There's like all your typical TTRPG board game kind of stuff. And then there's also we've been trying to decide, some of it's not tournament, some of it's just free play. We've been trying to decide what we should have that people would be most interested in, just in general. For the room, because again, we have limited time. The first day, I had just written down Halo Infinite for like our 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. slot on Friday, because like usually not many people are there. But again, we can change that. I put in some Tekken in there and Quiplash for people who don't want to play fighting games.
Yeah.
Is from 7 to midnight.
Okay.
Overwatch, Guilty Gear, Mario Kart, Rainbow Six. Apparently there's a big Civ 6 community around here. And, I don't know, CSGO, Smash. And that's all we really thought of. But I don't know, is there anything else that like people probably show us?
I mean, I'm biased. We'll just speak better. Realistically, like, if you have, like, an empty slot, I would put it in.
We have nothing written down for Sunday, right?
Yeah, if it's, like, a completely empty slot, it's, like, a good place to get anything else.
Fair.
Because, at least from you.
I heard games I like. What was this for?
Oh, so, Matacon.
I need to use the bathroom.
Do you use Comic-Con every year? I was asking for advice about, like, hey, is there anything you can think of that I don't have on this list for what we should put in for our land room? Because again, I know obviously there's a lot of fighting game stuff here, but you guys, you know, people play other stuff too.
Yeah.
And I don't have a lot of input from other people, so. But yeah, we've got a list.